Hello everyone. Today's topic of learning is vocabulary. Most often, an individual's ability to communicate is best judged when the person is able to use the right words probably in the right context. This comes with the same individual's strength in words with regard to any language for that matter. So let us try and see how much can we learn through the various aspects that deal with vocabulary. In continuation with that, we can start with trying to define what exactly is vocabulary. Well, vocabulary can be stated as something which can be called as the body of words used in a particular language, or a range of artistic, or maybe you can say stylistic forms, which may involve certain techniques. So it can also be termed as a word stock, you know, which can be called as a set of familiar words which a person can use to their advantage. It is usually developed with most often age, and sometimes serves as a useful and fundamental tool for communication as well as acquiring knowledge. So let us see how we can help ourselves with this tool called vocabulary. To start with, we might want to learn what exactly are the features that encapsulate this tool called vocabulary. Well, it is actually what I choose to define as, you know, a group of letters that can be added either at the beginning of a word or towards the end of a word, which we choose to call them as the terminology that is attributed to that is, you know, the first set of letters which could be added at the beginning of a word might be called as the prefixes. And the group of letters which are added towards the end of the word are called as suffixes. Now, we can see that there are many words, if we try to learn it with regard to parts of speech, you might end up learning how to make noun forms of a given verb, or probably learn how to make verbs out of nouns that are already given. For instance, here, we can take some very simple words, basic words. I'll start off with, let us say, a verb, that is do. So what is that? It's basically a verb, which is actually stating an action. So if I had to add these two letters, which we can see over here, the two letters being this U and N, well, we know that the meaning has undergone a massive change. So thereby, you're also learning to coin a new word. Similarly, the other examples, the keyword that is already given there is sincere. So again, let us remind ourselves that the letters that are used at the beginning of a word are called as prefixes. So here we are starting off with learning the use of prefixes. So with the keyword being sincere, most often it actually becomes the opposite of the word. Here, sincere, like we all know, is basically an adjective. So when you use the prefix in, it basically becomes exactly the opposite of that, which we also call as antonyms. It becomes insincere. Likewise, for judge, the prefix that we can see, which is being used over here, is mis. Again, another antonym, the antonym for the word judge, that is misjudge. Yeah, this is a little more constructive word, if I had to say. Biography, we can see that there are four letters added to the keyword that is biography. Now, the four letters here, we need to mind ourselves that it is a word in itself. It says auto. So in English, we mean to say when we use the word auto is actually anything that is self, that is something that can be done or generated on its own. So here, when we are talking of biography, it could be a biography of anyone. But when it says autobiography, it is perhaps the biography of the individual himself or herself. Likewise, what are the other ways we can, coin new words or learn new words? So far, the examples that were done over here were, or the words that we learned to make, were made out of letters that are used at the beginning of a word, which being termed as prefixes. So here, I would just like to add, which you may not be actually able to see over here. I just wanted to confirm, complete this by learning to use suffixes as well. So let me define suffixes. A group of letters that are added towards the end of the word could be termed as suffixes. Like we learned it in formation of words with the help of prefixes, it is pretty much the same in the case of suffixes. The suffixes can be two-lettered, three-lettered, four-lettered, depending on one's ability to, play with words as much as they would like to be able to enhance their strength in words. So this is how it is. For instance, let me take a word nation. I will right away go to the new word that is formed over here, national. So what has appeared in addition to the keyword that I already said, that is nation, are the two letters A and L. So there, the new word that you've coined is national. So there, the suffix, the use of the suffix AL has helped us to, think or create a new word called national. So here, national can be something which is more defining. Let us say an adjective, nation, the noun. Again here, another example, drive. Let me spell that for you, D-R-I-V-E. So it's a very simple way of changing, coming to a new word. I'm saying driver. When I say simple, I mean to say that the suffix that I've added over here is merely a single letter, that is R. So that makes it a driver. So here the driver is, when you look at with regard to parts of speech, it is the noun and drive is the verb. So this is what I thought I'll discuss. What we will learn with regard to the usage of prefixes and suffixes. So what we can see over here, in addition to what we have discussed so far, is compounding. How does that happen? Well, as we can see over there, when two or more stems are combined, it could be called as compounding. But what we need to know is how is that done? So for that, there are two ways. We are being taught over here to learn about these compounding words. Is one with the space, you will have two words, but they're separated by space, and the other one is with the use of a hyphen. So the one or two examples that you can see over here is party language. Okay, it's just a space that we use in a word. Nowadays we are supposed to use this language, everything is being done in soft copy, so it is a single space that is given between the two words, that is body language. Open book, same story. That is, the two words that are forming a compound word are merely separated by a single space. That's what we're supposed to learn over here. And the book club, similarly, it's just the space which is letting you know that it is one kind of a compound word. Now, the other aspect of a compound word that you can recognize, what we said is compound words which are separated with a hyphen. So women are really fond of colors. So when I say green, it is very, very vague. So when I have to be very specific, I might want to say a green which is sea green. So how am I making it a compound word here? You're letting us identify this compound word with the use of a hyphen. Earlier it was only a space. Now it is a hyphen. So the hyphen that you're giving between these two words, sea and green, is making it yet another compound word. Well, apart from that, these are few examples. High pitch, walking stick, we all know what this means. Walking stick is obviously an aid that people use to be able to walk. And high pitch is with regard to a person's voice or some sort of a modulation that you discuss in terms of voice. Well, there are compound words without a hyphen or space. That's interesting. Well, that is some. See, I'll just go to the word right away over here. I'm saying boardroom. I neither see a space over there nor a hyphen. Yet it becomes a compound word. So this is a third kind of a compound word that we get to learn without the use of hyphen and without any space between the two words. And the two words in this compound word being boat and room. Likewise, boatman, the two words, boat and man. Bookseller, the two words, book and seller. So that was pretty, even when I was discussing, I thought it was lots of fun to be able to learn words in such a definitive way. Okay.